Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Excel bootcamp course that you can find on my website at bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, in this video, we're going to add our amounts, okay, that has the dollar signs, great. Then we're going to make an option where when we add something to our quote, okay, so we're adding an InDesign course and we add some money to it. It's going to add them all up down the bottom for our subtotal. Then it's going to calculate the tax and give us our total all together. So let's go and do that now in this video. First thing is we're gonna put in just some dummy text. So over here, this is gonna be you're coming to an Excel course, okay, and I'm going to charge you, let's say $300. Now, at the moment, it doesn't have the currency symbol, so let's change that. So instead of selecting just this one, I want it to be for all of them. So we're gonna select all of these by clicking and dragging across all of them. And then up the top where it says general, we're under home. Okay, drop that down. There's a basic one in here called currency. Okay, and you might get lucky and it might give you the right symbol. Mine's giving me pounds. Okay, I don't want English pounds. I want either euros or dollars. So you go and change it. And there is a drop down here, okay, to these options. But if you want the full list, drop this down all the way down the bottom. It says more number formats, beyond currency. And you can see here's the symbol that I want. You can drop it down, there is a bunch in here. Okay, so depending on where you are in the world, okay, you'll find your option in here. I'm gonna find English, and I'm gonna use English, but United States. Great, let's click okay. So that's applied a currency formatting. It hasn't changed the number at all, just knows that it has the dollar signs. So next thing I'd like to do is I'd like to do the subtotal. Subtotal is really easy, it's just all of these added together. So what we'll do is we'll put in another one. Let's say you want to do a word course as well. I've got a word course, go check that out. And this one here is cheaper, not sure why. Okay, and one thing we will do is that the currency is right aligned here. I want them all to be right aligned, so select it all, right aligned. Okay, just to line up with these totals down the bottom here. So our first bit of formula work, okay, is just to add everything in this column and put it here in the subtotal. We'll add the tax next. Okay, and we're gonna use something called AutoSum, the most common and easiest Excel formula to do. And it appears in lots of different panels. You can kind of see him. I've got the selector down here. He's down the bottom here, nice and small. If you've got a smaller screen, you might have to go to formulas. And here he is right at the beginning and just click AutoSum. And it's gone up and reached up and said, would you like all of this? And it's close, okay? So I'm gonna say, kind of, I want you. Actually, I'm gonna drag across them. I want all of these. There's no point having that one in there. Okay, so just drag across all the ones you want. You can manually type it in here. You can see it's running from column I along the top. Okay, 18, which is there. So I18, all the way down to I35, which is this last option here. I'm gonna click return on my keyboard. You can see there, it's added it up. It's added the dollar sign as well, made it the right currency. Awesome Excel stuff. Okay, and yeah, that's it for adding things up using AutoSum. Let's calculate the tax next. Okay, so to calculate tax, click on my tax cell. You might call it VAT or GST or sales tax, whatever you wanna call it. Okay, we're calculating some sort of tax rate. To do it, click in the cell and up here in our formula bar, we're gonna start it with an equals. This is just telling, this is really important. It tells Excel that we are not typing words, we are typing a little formula. And what I wanna do is I want to take this subtotal here. So I'm just gonna click on with my mouse. Okay, you can see it added it to there automatically. I can just type it in. Then I want to times this by my tax rate. Tax rate can't be typed in as a percentage in formulas. It needs to be a decimal place. Okay, so it's going to be 0 point something. And you need to find out what it is for your country or your state in your country. There's so much. Where I'm at the moment, Ireland, okay, it's 23%. Okay, and if I hit return, I have that tax. Okay, and in New Zealand, it's 15, which I thought was high. Went up to that from 12.5. Okay, 23 is a lot higher. Okay, and if you're in some states of America, I know it's 7.5, and this is, I guess, a little bit interesting. You need to put in 0.75. Okay, because if you don't, and you put in 7.5, that's gonna be 75% tax. That's pretty high. Okay, so it needs to be 0.075, and that'll give you your tax. Nice. Let's add these two together for our total. So I'm gonna click in this total cell and I'm going to, there's a couple of ways I can do it. I can do auto sum or I can just do equals and I'm gonna say you. Okay, you see it picks it there. I'm gonna hit plus. and then I'm going to click U, and then I'm going to hit return, and that's going to give me my total. My subtotal plus my tax equals this. Happy days. Let's test it works. Let's say we've done this. You're going to now do my, say, my Photoshop course. I've got one of those too. Okay, and but that's super awesome and it's super expensive. Say it's 700. Okay, you can see it's calculated it, calculated the tax, and has my total. Happy days. All right, let's get into the next video where we'll look at adding and removing these columns in case we have extra stuff that needs to fill it in. Let's go do that now. Hey, did you enjoy it? If you did, please click subscribe or like, click the little alert bell as well. All of these things really help me as a business. Also, if you want the full course, check out the Excel Bootcamp on bringyourownlaptop.com. There's that course plus many others. All right, bye now.